In this tutorial, I try to explain the difference between using the Windows volume to increase the loudness of a sound and pre-amplifying a sound which also increases its loudness. As you have probably noticed, PS has two sliders, both affecting the loudness of the output sound. When you want to increase the output volume of a song, for instance, you may use either slider. But there is a significant difference between the two, and this difference isn't that obvious, so let me explain. But first, to be thorough, I'll show the positions of both sliders. For pre-amplifying the sound, you use this slider. It's the same as the one in the piece menu of the Windows System tray. Talking about the System Windows tray, for changing the volume, you commonly use this slider, which is the same as the one on the piece interface, below the peak volume meter. Perhaps a good way to explain the difference between increasing the Windows volume and increasing the pre-amplification is showing it in this image. Here you see a sound with a certain volume on the y-axis. A sound has a range limited by a maximum and a minimum value in which it can have its loudness expressed. When you increase the Windows volume, the sound isn't increased within this range. Rather, the whole range, including the sound, is increased, or better said, amplified. This is in contrast to pre-amplification. In this case, only the sound loudness is increased, not the entire range. For weak input sounds, this can be very useful. A certain song might have a low loudness in itself, which benefits from some pre-amplification instead of just increasing the Windows volume. Of course, you can use the Windows volume to make it louder if you want to. Another example is a weak sound coming in from your microphone. Although in this case pre-amplifying the sound will also pre-amplify the noise coming from the microphone. To deal with this noise is beyond the scope of this tutorial, but I'll give you two ways to do this: noise reduction and sound gating. Although it can be very useful to amplify a sound to a level which corresponds to all the other sounds, for instance amplifying a played song to a level of other songs, it may also present us with a common issue. When pre-amplifying too strongly, the sound will go beyond the possible volume range of your computer. If it does, it will clip as shown here. This will be noticeable by some degree of sound distortion. Besides this hearable distortion, the peak value meter will fill up to go deeply into the red. This indicator will light up too much. Then you'll know your sound is clipping and the pre-amplifying slider needs to be dialed down.